Welcome. So my name is Darlene, and today I'll be filming the intro for my 18 in 2018 project pan. I know it's a little bit late, but better late than never. First set of items I'm going to be trying to pan are in a palette. This is the, how about them apples? Lip and cheek palette. I would like to hit pan on every color. I greatly enjoy using this. It's just something I don't reach for the way I should, and I'm not sure why. It was a gift and I want to put it to some use, so hopefully I can get some good use out of it this year. And for those of you who are interested in swatches, this is Cider, Cobbler, Pie, Crisp, Caramel, and Candy. The next set of items that I will be using is also in a palette. This is the Becca and Jaclyn Hill collaboration from, I think, 2 years ago. As you can see, I already have a very big pan in both Pearl and Champagne Pop, and a decent dip in Blushed Copper. I would like to use up both Champagne Pop and Pearl, and hit pan on Blushed Copper. I used Blush Copper as an eyeshadow because I am too fair to use it as a face product. The next item is in a pot. This is an RMS Beauty lip shine in the color Sublime. It is a really moisturizing formula and I really enjoy it, but these pots take forever to go through. And even though I've been working on this for a very long time, it is still clinging in. So, and for those of you who are interested, this shiny, shiny pink glossy color is Sublime. Now, the next item I am trying to get rid of and pan is this black eyeliner from Marc Jacobs. This was in a birthday gift from 2 years ago. I don't use a lot of black eyeliner. I'll twist it all the way up for you guys. You can see where I'm at, which this is almost completely brand new, so I need to start using this and try and use it up. I figure if I make myself use it, it won't last long because there's not a whole bunch of product in here. I just need to do it. The next product is a little bit more hard to show you guys. It is a loose pigment from Modern Minerals. To my knowledge, all of their products are loose pigments or tube glosses. This is in the shade Leo, and it is a beautiful gold color. But I am very, very rough when I do my makeup, and I find that if I'm not careful, I make a huge mess. So I don't prefer loose pigments. It is also by itself not very opaque, it's very sheer, so you have to put down a sticky base or foil it, which it does not tolerate, foiling very well. So, like, this is it on top of the crayon I am also going to be using up. This is it by itself, which is still pretty, but like on the eyes, it just doesn't have a punch the same way layering it does. Now, I will be layering that with the Beauty Basics Sahara Gold Crayon. I think I got this in an Ipsy bag a while ago. I just haven't used it. This was brand new at the start of the year. I've sharpened it once, and it's got a long way to go. So I will be pairing this with that Leo shade from Modern Minerals. And that is actually this slightly, kind of hard to tell, slightly more say more champagne colored gold. More orangey based. Now, the next product is also a lip product. I have two more lip products in front of me. This one and a gloss. This is Foxglove from 100% Pure. This is all I have left. It is a very, very soft formula. So as you're using it, it moves around a lot. Like as you can see here, it's already come loose from where it is inside the tube. So I have to be careful with it. I have no doubt in my mind that I will have this done by my next check-in. It's not going to be difficult for me. I will not be repurchasing more of these because they are just too soft and I don't want to worry about my lipstick falling apart on me when I'm trying to put it on. The last lip product I have is a Meant to Be lip gloss from Red Apple Lipstick, which is a gluten-free makeup brand. I am down here. This is a very moisturizing lip gloss and I really enjoy using it. It's in the shade Honey Badger. I will enjoy using that up. Now, the next thing I have is a California Mango Mingle Magic Cuticle Oil. It is right here. I enjoy this. I carry this with me to work. If I put my mind to it, I'm sure I can use this up no problem. I'm already about a quarter of the way done with it. I just have to use it. And sometimes I go weeks without using it, which is bad. And then the next thing I have is a perfume from Scentbird. I have a handful of these from Scentbird. Not necessarily this fragrance, but other ones. I was trying at one point to find a perfume that is kind of my, like, what I want to smell like always and forever. I have yet to find it. These are pleasant, but they're not my favorite. So I'm starting right here. And the scent is Be Delicious, which is nice. Just, I need to use it or it's gonna sit here and I'm never gonna touch it. Now, my last item is a Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser Concealer. I am down to here. I have to be very careful when I use this. If I put on too much, my under eyes look really, really dry. My under eyes are already dry and I have a lot of fine lines and it doesn't seem to help my darkness. I still have to go in with a color corrector. So I would like to use this up and move it out. It is also no longer the lightest shade from what I am told. I have it in fair and maybe a lighter shade will help. So yeah, that's where we're at. That is all 18 of my products for the pan. Hopefully I can make some decent progress. I'm planning on doing updates every 4 weeks, so expect that 4 weeks from today I will be posting a update and we'll see how I can do. Thank you for watching. Bye.